work in progress here. As you can see, there's a big gap there that I tried squeezing to get in, but clamps couldn't even get it closed, so I'm gonna have to fill that right there. I'm gonna fill that with putty. Right now I'm clamping and epoxying these panels on for the thrusters to connect, which is kind of weird because you see the three holes there? They go vertical, right? But if you look on the thrusters, they go vertical. So I don't know. It's just a matter of probably I'll have to sand those off and then just, I don't know, figure something out. So what I mean, when you're doing a piece like this, it's always a like work in progress. You always kind of like got to figure out what you're going to do next, how you're going to do it, how's the best way to do it. Hell, I'm even holding it straight up with a bucket and some towels and sheets just to get it to go straight up and down. So that's number two. We're almost there. Almost to the point of priming soon, I hope. Then this goes on the back here. It's gonna fit in there. And we have added some lights to it. Let me get a 9-volt battery. And you just positive and negative, pretty easy. Gotta try to get it to go on there by holding it with one hand, just so we can see what it looks like. Maybe. Probably not. There. Real simple. As you can see, they're in the back there and they're glued. I use a quick drying bond. It's almost like Elmer's glue. I'm not sure what you call this, what kind of glue this is, but PVA glue, okay. And this just dries quicker than Elmer's. Elmer's takes a little while to dry, and they'll stand straight up for you after they dry. It dries pretty quickly. But you don't want to use CA glue on LED lights, because what it'll do is it'll cloud the LED and it'll have a chemical reaction which clouds the plastic for the LED. Yeah, like I said, I'm just gonna put this piece on next when that dries, and then do all the greeblies on here, which is, I'm gonna use bendy straws, the crinkly part of the bendy straw, for some hoses that go from the thruster to the ship. Yeah, so it's going along, and we'll show you the next progress. All right, so progress right now is that we're about ready to prime it. Pretty much built, added some kit parts, and got some parts made, cast, that are supposed to be with the kit that didn't come with the kit. Got those styrene rods put back on. Added some jeweler's wire, added some kits from parts from my model kit inventory, which is growing all the time lately, because I'm kind of done with resin kits. I'm just kind of done with them. I like building scratch, so Just showing some parts before I prime it, because you see it, but it kind of gets covered a lot because of the primer. More. Oh, in the back. So the back is where all the magic is at for this piece, the engine. It's got a lot of cool kit parts. More kit parts there, more kit parts there. Inside is really cool. I like that part. And all the wiring is ready and to go inside. One coming out the bottom. So that all I gotta do is string it through there and light up the back. So just want to show the bare kit before I prime it. Kind of show you where the work was done. Oh, these were bare. These were not fun to do. These styrene strips in here, not fun at all. Kind of a pain in the butt. But we're gonna prime it and it'll be ready to throw the first base coat of paint on. And we'll pick up back again when that is all done. Okay, so we're about to prime it. We're gonna do the bottom first in the garage. Here I'm using this plutonium. It's actually a spray paint, but works as a primer too, and sticks really, really, really good. Kind of switched over. My buddy Jason told me about this, and it's pretty nice stuff. So yeah, we'll get started. Thank you. So we're gonna work on the wings. On these resin kit, this resin kit, there were little resin globs. They're supposed to be tabs, but they're globs that I just cut off. Pretty much you can't really even work with it. I marked where the spots are that they should be, that the tabs were at. And I'm gonna drill some new holes to put in copper rods. Cause these slot right into the engines and from the top and the bottom, well, reverse, top and the bottom. So, I already did a couple of them, but just to show you the process, I have this little electric drill. It's just for tiny bits, and whenever you're drilling a hole like this, you know, I have to get it right in the middle. Start small and then work yourself up to a larger, to the size that you need. I'll start with this because this is, you know, this is a small bit and it don't need much control, but as I get bigger, I have to use the hand one to try to get it to be more controlled and not blow out the side. So we'll just do one, and I did that one. I did that one. Which one didn't I do? I'm pretty sure it was this one. All right. Well, yeah. All right. Here it is. Okay. So, just a little handheld drill. I'm gonna keep my fingers there. It's real slow and small, so it won't cut into my fingers. But I'm gonna line it up right there. And just slowly push it in. And I can actually feel the heat. So if it gets too hot, I know I'm coming too close to the side. So I can just push it over a little bit. A couple of them. Like I can feel it just starting to push a little bit to the side. And then I'll go with the handheld one and make a larger hole by hand. All the while still holding it tight so I don't blow through the sides and keeping it lined up in the middle as best I can. If I blow it out, I can just put the rod in and then putty the side, but try not to do that because I just won't get it. There. There's one. And the second one. Because the original smaller hole will guide you pretty much where you're going. You can adjust it a little bit if you feel like it's getting too close to the side, which I can feel this one is. So I'll just pull back a little bit and turn and push towards this side so that it evens out a little bit. It'll actually like file this edge if you're pushing that way. That's all there is to it. And then I don't have the rods yet, but I'll just take a rod and it'll go in there and it'll be fine. New pegs. Easy peasy. Paint time. All right. We're painting the reefer white on the A-wing. And using ArchiveX reefer white acrylics. I am not talented enough to come up with my own colors, so I am going to go with these. They are, by more educated people than me, knowing that this is color matching this to the to paint chips off of the original miniatures, the original models. So looks good to me. I mean, I'm very terrible at picking up colors. So in fact, I'm always asking somebody, all right, what's this color? What's this color? What's this color? What's color? And so, yeah, we have primed it in. It's black, the plutonium black I use now. It's actually worked pretty good for me, thanks to Jason. We have some latex masking on the sides for some scratches, some weathering on this side and this side, right there. Yeah, so it's gonna require a lot of white paint, I can tell already. And I'm prepared. I got a couple boxes of reefer white. So, ready to go. Here we go. Okay, so did that in stages, let that dry, let that dry. I'm going to blow dry that a little bit and then just touch it up on that side and then flip it over the other side. I didn't really worry too much about getting it completely white in the middle because that's going to get red. And I find that with Archive-X, the reefer white, I haven't noticed it with any of the others, but the reefer white has like a different, little bit of a different consistency, density than the, I don't know if that's the right word, than all the other colors. It seems a little bit more, I don't know if soapy is the word, or just like the more fluid. You gotta be careful of not putting on too much, because then you get runs like that. But I'll take care of that. I'll dry it and then go over it a little bit more just to bury it underneath more paint. But yeah, it's the bottoms use a lot less paint than I thought it was going to. So we're gonna flip it to the other side and then touch up some details, and then I'll probably let this sit a night and let it cure pretty good, and then tape it up for the reefer, for the caboose red.
Not caboose red. Boxcar red.
It's 75 boxcar red. So, all right, on to the next stage. On to the front. The top, sorry. Have this all taped up because I want to keep that black. Because I want to use armor gray for the cockpit then with a black primer. We're just gonna, like I said, there's some weathering on the side with the latex mask. And we're just gonna go over the top now and get this white ready to go. So, got a couple coats on, roll that dry, and then put the final coat on. Like I said, this reefer white is a little bit more watery than the other ones for some reason, to me at least. But that's why I put more layers on. This is what, third layer, so probably one or two more and it should cover pretty good. We're getting there. All right.